that's us on now. So, who fancies doing a recap of what happened last time we played? Bear in mind that Finn's not been here for a couple of weeks. So, might have to go back further than just last session.
Zarazan got nabbed by an army. Narian went to go save him, and then got nabbed himself. Lost all his things.
Yep.
Then Raffin came to speak to him
and save
him.
You skipped over the part where Narian successfully saved him.
Success is a strong word. Narian got Zarazan freed in exchange for a little switcheroo. And then Raffin came and swooped him out of there, losing all his things.
Including Nautilus.
Including Nautilus, who was not happy about it. Ruek magicked up a temple that he just remembered he could do. That's pretty solid of him. Everyone else went on a cake run at the nearby city as clouds, as you do. Zerger, you came with us. Kind of just standing there ominously, 1,000 yards away. Sorath? Is that your new character's name?
Yes.
Sorry, yeah. Swindled some poor blacksmith out of their nails.
Nice.
That wasn't swindled, I was overcharged for those nails.
Yeah, that was about it, I think. And now there's an army. But we also have cake.
Isn't
the army like on our front door right now?
Yeah. Oh, and the best news is like 20% of our army is fucked up somewhere. Yeah, all looking pretty peachy.
Hey, can I answer your earlier question? No, optimistic.
Yeah. that's not everything. They have numbers and scary wizards.
Of will and friendship.
And cake.
We will succeed. And cake, especially
and cake.
And
we
alcohol.
Have cake over them. And alcohol.
Let's get steaming, go out there. Oh, I'll fucking kill you!
Maybe we can just invite the enemy army to like a party. And they'll just, you know, chill out a little bit.
We can poison them.
It's worth a try, you know?
Yeah, that's about the size of things, really.
Nice.
Yeah, okay. We had finished last week. Hang on, I got anything I gotta do before that? Last week I had said I'd given you a measure of there's this many sessions until the final battle. I was mostly doing that as a diagnostic tool to let you guys know how close to being totally fucked you were. But I've now got a new measure with the new rulebook for how close the final battle is. So I'm going to ditch that. I was going to update it like on a week-to-week basis and be like, there's this many sessions. So you had an idea of how close you were skirting. But I'm going to throw that plan out the window. So ignore what I said last week. Put anything else I got? Nope, not really. Last week we had finished off with the army... the 5th Legion arriving outside your temple, but there had been 2 hours of kind of hauling up in your temple waiting for them to turn up, during which time, you know, we can still do some stuff then if anyone wanted to do anything then. Narin, you got captured by them briefly.
Yes.
So you know... Yeah, I mean, the upside of that is you have it, you know, you've seen their army up close, you kind of know what's going on there. So you know, having been captured by them, that the army that you're about to go up against has 3 units of heavy archers and 2 units of medium infantry. So they've got like 3 lots of black barbs, basically, and 2 lots of Sorgar's infantry equivalent. So you're aware. Also, they've got all your stuff, so you don't have your tridents, you have your hand tridents, you've lost your belt of hill giant strength, they've got that, so your strength's not 21 anymore. You've not got your cloak. You've not got your armor. Did you have the bag of holding with you?
Yes.
Okay, well, you don't have that anymore.
Oh my god.
And they've got your shell.
Our buddies in there!
They've got your shell as well. Unless that was in the bag of holding, in which case they also still have it, but they just don't know that they have it. Or maybe they do.
What are the chances that some random fucker in the army just decided to blow into that, huh?
It's not zero.
is it the ones that...
That's fine. We'll get a bet.
Yeah. So you're currently basically running around in, like, effectively your skivvies. You've got just, like, whatever clothes you wear under your armor is all you've really got. Like, you know, they left you with enough to, you know, keep you decent. I don't know, I guess you've got, like, a shirt and trousers on, but you don't have any weaponry or armor. So what is Naren's plan?
Did he not say the other week that he was gonna spend the time making Naren?
Oh, he did, yeah.
I think
you started doing that.
Was just gonna claim a weapon that was lying about. Not a trident.
Sure, okay.
I'm pretty sure there's an evil fucking spear lying around somewhere. Unless that was also in the bag of holding, then we do not have an ear. Evil spear kicking about.
I think most of our shit was in the bag of holding.
Yeah.
Unrelated
note. Is anyone else using D&D Beyond, and is it working for them? Because it's not working for me.
Yeah, it's working for me.
It's working for me.
It's not good stuff.
Yeah, I know. It's not letting me be my character. I don't know why.
That's quite weird.
I'll try a different thing. Sorry, continue.
Like, Naren, you're able to... Rurik won't have time. He's only got 2 hours. So even though he's pretty good, he's not going to be able to make you, like, a full suit of plate mail or anything like that. He might be able to bash out a breastplate. That's probably about the best you can do. But you've got an army with you. They've got spare stuff. So you can probably find...
Is there a shield lying about?
Oh, yeah, there'll be a shield lying about, yeah. Shields, longswords, spears, chainmail. Probably you could find enough to equip yourself.
Yeah, I'll equip some chainmail, a shield. Am I able to wield a spear with one hand?
Seeing
as
yes.
I can wield a trident
with
one.
Yeah, you can, yeah.
Guess I'll go shield and spear.
Yeah. Okay. So Naren dresses up as Sargon.
But better.
Ooh. Zarzan, you also were captured by them. So you got a look at their units, and you also overheard the wizard talking about stuff, so I will send you the stat blocks for the units, because this part might not mean anything to you. There's a new warfare system, if anyone hasn't, I don't know, I mentioned, but I don't know if people saw, but there is a new system for warfare. So some of the unit blocks have changed. So let me send this to Noel. So that is kind of the extent of the information I needed to give people. So how are you guys spending your 2 hours, if indeed you were spending it in any capacity?
Naren is probably going to, after gathering some equipment, pray to Orisa.
Sure, okay. I believe Rurik set up a kind of discount altar in the corner for other gods. Sure, give us a religion check then. You get a pretty sort of a, obviously there's no chat, but you get a fairly kind of curt response kind of feeling that makes you super aware of the fact that you no longer have her special trident or the shell she gave you, and you're phoning her from her ex-husband's house.
I recognize this number.
So you feel pretty, you know, in tune with her, just that she's hacked off.
I guess Naren would spend the remainder of his time readying the truth.
Sure, okay. What is it? So how are Naren and Zorgar reacting to the whole situation you guys are in right now? Like, is this like a Helm's Deep situation where you're like, God, this is going to be rough?
I'm not really sure. I'm still processing all the information I just received.
Sure. Okay.
Naren is very much in the mindset of, this is really fucking bad.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go out in a blaze of glory.
Okay.
Yeah, that's kind of where I was thinking as well.
Sure. Okay. So you're just kind of like, chilling people up, you know, like, so well, it'll be fun.
Zorgar's gonna eat some cake.
Uh-huh, yeah, there is cake.
He's gonna have maybe two slices, he's feeling desperate. Then he's gonna have a wee pray.
Uh-huh.
And then he's gonna go and talk to everyone and try... He's talking to everyone to, like, you know, hype them up, but he's really trying to hype himself up.
Sure, okay, yeah. Sure.
He's like, you know, he's being optimistic to everyone. He's like, if we stay together, we can fight strong. But inside, he's just telling that to himself.
Sure. Okay. So Zorgar's kind of trying to shift people along. Naren's doing the same. What about Muir? What are Muir and Raffin and Sarith and Zarsin up to?
I think Raffin would be resting up after his exertions.
Sure.
Healing up and things.
Just kind of relaxing in the corner. Anyone else doing anything in particular?
Zarzan's gonna fill in the lads on what he knows about what's coming.
Good.
So, probably find Naren, I guess.
Sure.
And Zorgar.
I mean, you know, at some point they might converge on you to try and shove you along by the sounds of it. But yeah, they're around. You're able to find them both fairly easily.
So, from what I gathered, there are archers and infantry on the way, each with a size of 6. There might also be some airborne units as well.
Hang on, what? I didn't see any drakes. Did you see drakes?
I have heard that they've been dispatched.
Ah, fuck. Of course they have. How wooden is this temple?
It's made of, like, kind of weird spectral stone. The ceiling is transparent. But it's also made of stone, which is quite a weird sensation.
It's pretty convenient, that. All right.
I'm just gonna shunt people into the battle scene. It should be mostly fogged over, but there should be a chunk where you can see your guys' units. Because the cards have changed because of the new system. Some of that probably won't mean all that much yet, but just as you can get a comparison point. Sorry, continue. If indeed there is anything to continue.
Jake, how does my war magic work now?
It's a short answer. Not, it doesn't really.
Okay. I also got to do one cool thing.
Yeah. But the flip side of that is that the wizard's war magic doesn't work either.
Thank you. Right.
So.
No giant laser beam then?
I will explain. I'll go over that if it comes down to a fight. Well, I mean, I don't know. You guys surprise me. Look, it's obviously heading in that trajectory, but
maybe we can veer it off course rapidly.
Yeah, maybe.
Cake, souls, all.
So Zarzan goes over and fills Naren and Zorgar in. Is anyone else doing anything, or are you just sort of waiting for them to turn?
Drinking.
Nice.
I might go and look around the outside of this temple bit, see if the path the army's going to come up is all rather slanted and annoying to get up.
It's the same path you guys went up. So it's not like brilliant. There are some traps that have been laid by Gek, that might, you know, milky them a wee bit. It'll kind of, like, it's not.
It's been raining recently, hasn't it? Because of the storm thing.
It's snowing right now.
Oh, even amazing. Can I just do some, like, cantrip Ray of Frost on the ground, make it super slippy for
sure,
me?
Sure, okay, yeah.
that's the only thing I can do.
Sure, okay. It's probably not going to do anything like tremendous, but it's going to inconvenience them.
Yeah, that's all I can do. That's my main role here.
Sure.
Is Rurak's orb still up?
Maybe.
Storm.
I don't know. Maybe. Probably. Seems like something Rurak would do, isn't it?
Is Rurak's with us though, right?
Yeah, he's hanging around. He's smithing in the corner right now.
In spirit.
Is someone going to run, right? I realized we didn't kind of figure that one out.
I can do it.
Okay.
I'll ask him if there's anything he wants me to do, Shrek.
Probably not die.
It's ideal, really, in most scenarios. Mm-hmm. Sure, so the other thing you guys should be aware of is that right now it's like midnight. Like, it's like nighttime. Which is obviously not the best scenario to be fighting a battle in. But it's equally bad for them, so.
We're inside, we're fine.
You are inside.
Lit torches.
Yeah. Can Mirror, like, get, is there, like, backpacks and things lying about, because it's an army?
Probably, yeah.
Can I find a small one and, like, put some rations and, like, a torch or just, like, general supply stuff?
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to spell store invisibility on a or just the most interesting looking rock or small item I have.
Okay.
And go find Gek.
Yeah, he's he's probably just sitting in the corner eating cake. Like he's got like a it takes you a while to find him. He's kinda sitting in like a shadow of like a pillar in the corner with like a whole cake. And he's kinda like eating it, and he kinda like as you come into view, he kind of like, or as you notice him, he kind of gasp hisses at you, and he starts like shoveling it into his face.
It's all yours, buddy. All yours. Just forget. That's fine. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Gek, what I've got here is if things go really bad, what I want you to do is if you think really hard while holding this, holding up the invisibility thing, you'll turn invisible, okay? I want you to shuffle up that. No one can see you. I'm
super stealthy.
Yeah, you're like that, but even more. Nobody will ever be able to see you, okay?
You can't see me, and Narn can't see me.
Yeah, no, nobody.
I want people to be able to see me.
Oh, yeah, don't worry. It's just if things go very bad, okay, because there's not some very not nice people coming, I want you to use it and scramble out that back window, okay? And find a nice little tree hollow to hide in. And I'll come and find you, I promise.
Okay.
I've got all sorts of fun things in here, so I want you to keep this with you. Okay? Yeah, all yours. Just for Gek.
Forever?
Forever. Can even put some cake in there.
Soldier's backpack. Gone missing.
He kind of holds up, it's like a real big gourd.
Yeah, real big gourd.
Can I have both?
You can have both. You can put your gourd in the other big gourd.
That gives me so much space. If I have loads of gourds, and I put all the gourds in the bag, it's like having a bag of stuff and also gourds of stuff.
Exactly, Gek.
Why isn't everyone... No one's ever done this before. I'm gonna make so much money with this ID. Okay.
Alright, you're gonna have
to... He starts like taking stuff out, throwing it around, and like looking through it.
Okay,
seems boring.
I want you to keep all, like, that's the only thing.
What is this thing? He holds up a torch. It's sticky.
If you light it, you know, fire, it will stay on fire for a while, so you can see. Or you can, you know, keep warm, okay?
I can hit things.
Cool. Or hit things, you know, it's very multi-purpose.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Okay, so that in return for Big Gourd, you gotta keep all that stuff in until all this is over, okay?
Okay.
You promise?
Okay.
Promise?
There's a good girl. Okay. I'll do that.
Okay, cool.
Put all this stuff back again. Is this cheese? Right. I can't believe that. No.
Alright. Okay, cool. Okay. So what are you gonna do if there's trouble?
I'm gonna... hit things.
No. What are you gonna do first?
I'll run away. Out the window. Fine. What if I'm not in here?
Run away.
If I outside, do I have to run in window to run out window again?
No, Gek.
Okay.
Just watch. You're good. You're sneaky. Find somewhere to hide. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Cool.
Okay.
Give him a head pat. That's what I wanted to do.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. You see, the rest of the time he's like. Kind of like sitting through and looking at stuff and putting it back in, and he's like taking stuff out of his gourd and like putting it in pockets and stuff, and he looks like he's really enthused by this backpack. Is anyone else doing anything, or are you guys just waiting for them to show up?
Can I make the terrain, it's like with plant growth, I can make the terrain difficult, can't I?
Mm-hmm, yeah. It won't really do anything. Other than it will take them slightly longer to get here, but you can actually go and do that, yeah?
I'll do that.
Sure.
Takes them a bit longer.
Sure, okay. Alright. Well, if anyone else had anything they're wishing to get up to, then about 2.5 hours later, about 2 hours later, people start seeing soldiers kind of appear, and it takes about 2.5 hours. As they all kind of like march into position around the temple, and then let me change the tunes.
Are they immediately aware that there's an army in the temple?
Well, they're aware that there was an army up here, and then there is now a temple that wasn't here before.
Were they here before? How do they know?
You have to go out and ask them. So yeah, there's this, you hear the sound of marching boots, kind of continues and is fairly incessant for about half an hour, grows steadily louder as they start to surround the building. And then after a few moments, after that stops, a voice calls out and says, "Ho there! I am Captain Vassad of the 5th Legion of Scale. Why don't you come out and talk as equals? There is no need for bloodshed this day." You hear that voice emanate from outside.
I agree. There is no need for bloodshed today. But I'm going to stay in here and you can talk to us through this wall.
You will not come out and face me?
Will you promise that even if things go to bloodshed, you'll let me return in here first?
Very well.
Jake, how honorable does this man seem to me?
Does
he strike me as an honorable
Everything
man?
He has told you he would do, he has done.
Okay, yeah.
No, he released Zarzan in the exact manner, you know, in the exact manner that he said he would.
He also let Zarzan have the stone.
Mm-hmm,
oh yeah, can I have my stone back, Zarzan? Alright, we can do this later. I've kind of got a meeting to go to now. Naren's gonna go out. I'm not sure Zorgal's going out.
Yeah, is anyone else going out?
I'll go with.
Sure. Yeah, so you guys ease the temple doors out, open and step outside, and you can see there's like this kind of big semicircle of units of soldiers kind of surrounding the temple. And there's like a clearing in front of the doors, and standing there are the captain and the wizard kind of behind him. Captain sees copper scaled, he's wearing dragonglass armor, he's got a sword and a shield, both, you know, scabbarded and on his back, and he kind of watches you emerge, and he says, "Ale."
Nice to see you again.
Ale.
"I will speak plainly to you. We are willing to accept the surrender of you and your companions, the elves, the wizard, the mage rite, in exchange for the lives of your Vak."
I'm gonna be blunt straight off the bat here. We can't meet those terms because our wizard left a while ago.
I find that difficult to reconcile with the arcane display this afternoon.
That's someone else I met the other day. I don't.
So he kind of narrows his eyes.
"Oh, that's my other pal, sorry."
To have things on good faith, would you consider returning my stuff to me?
He looks at you and he smiles and he says, "I have no intention of returning the belongings to a prisoner I'm about to take, willingly or no."
"Would you not return them to my troops who will they go free if we hand ourselves up?"
"Let us deal with that after we have you in our..." "care."
"Wait, so you're not even going to tell us if our troops will be allowed to leave or not?"
"Oh, they will be allowed to leave." "The Scalar has made it very clear he's willing to forgive your Vak and their part in this farce."
"I see."
"The alternative is, of course, for them to die on this mountaintop. Which I am certain neither you nor I wish to happen."
Would you mind if we discuss this with the rest of our party?
Certainly, bring them in.
Okay, that was meaning like privately, but you know.
We were going to go in.
We'll be back in just a minute.
Dicks?
He kind of, he looks at the, he kind of narrows it, he's like, very well. You see him whisper something to the wizard.
How good is knowing a reading lips?
He like turns and has like a cup whisper.
Like a little bitch.
Also, how good is Zorgar's lips?
It's not good enough for that. It's like, it's snowing, you're at the top of a mountain, so it's windy.
Aaron is keeping his eye, he's looking up every now and then, watching for the drakes.
Sure, you don't see any sign of them yet. Or in fact, give us a perception check. Give us a perception check.
Maybe it's windy because there's so many drakes coming.
The flaps of their wings is crazy.
Oh, it was almost a 20.
Tarkin, you can't see anything right now, but it's like the visibility is quite poor. Because it's dark, it's at night, you know, there's a lot of cloud cover, snowing.
Okay. Well, I guess we'll go in and discuss it with the party then.
He says, just kind of as you turn to leave, he says, I'm sure you appreciate, Captain, that I can't grant you indefinite leave. I can give you 5 minutes.
Will you give us a countdown towards the end?
Certainly.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Okay, let's hurry in and discuss. So, you guys want to surrender? On this one?
Are they spying on us? Just to make that... Let's get that out of the way.
We have limited time here. Just by the way, we didn't tell you that yet. So. It's given us 5 minutes to discuss what to do with you. He wants us to surrender, obviously. He wants us to give ourselves over or die. Those are the options he gave us.
My camera's gone, hold on. Sorry.
I mean, I'm willing to fight this to the death if you guys are.
I'm also willing to fight this to the death.
I am concerned that we have Zorgar's mum and his brother or sister here. And Gek and others, and Sora.
Maybe we should ask for the.
I don't trust your brother's word that everybody here is gonna get to go home, to be honest.
Have you tried convincing the enemy army?
We do have cake.
I mean, it's cold. We do have the speech lord.
We could warm the cake up.
People to chant their own career. We could start the army chant and convince them just all one army.
We could invite the guy in for a drink and some cake.
He would not agree to that.
Well,
it's good cake.
And we didn't do anything bad, maybe he'll see that we're actually good guys.
Maybe if we offer him hot chocolate.
Hold on, I think I might actually have a spell.
Cake and a drink out.
The hospitality, you know?
He's like, wow, the hospitality.
3 minutes remaining.
What if we bring cake and a drink out to him and we poison the drink?
What if we spike the cake and drink?
I'm pretty sure they can hear us. Just putting this out there.
Don't do that!
Why not? That seems like a plan.
Raise the point of Balasar is a cunt.
We're trying to kill them with kindness, not with them.
Okay,
no, but if we just get him stoned, he'll be way more open to our ideas.
That's true.
So you know you've got good ideas.
Good.
You know how we got out of Colborne, right? With the, I'm very conscious. I'm pretty sure it's blown up. But
the solution. But yes, I remember.
We could. I'm pretty sure if everybody huddled close enough,
the entire army.
It's not that many people here, Naren. Sorry to tell you.
There's over 100 people.
Could. How many people, how many people, if they really squeezed, could fit in a 30-foot circle?
Is that radius or diameter?
If I'm the point it's and radius. It's 30 feet at 15 at each.
That's diameter.
Yeah, that's the one.
So it would be quite a lot.
Roughly
if you stacked, if you piled into a dome, a suffocatory
really
dome.
Yeah.
There'd be a couple of stragglers left behind them.
That's not so bad.
There's a lot.
I could stay behind.
How many stragglers are we talking about? Can we get?
I don't know. There would have to be a roll. It would probably be percentile dice to see you get that many people in with you.
I think you get a lot of people in there.
I'm sure someone's done the math on this online. Oh, let me.
I'm sure you got this many people to follow you now. Surely you can convince some more.
Okay. That's the plan we're rolling with for now because we're running out of time. I don't know how long we've got left.
1 minute bad at counting remains. Now.
Okay, there we go. I say we just go out with, a cake and a drink. We offer it to him. He'll probably refuse because he'll think we're going to make him fine. We try and convince his soldiers, giving a big speech. We'll try and get Nautilus back with some barter.
Okay.
And then we fight to the death.
Yeah, okay.
Sure you don't want to just...
I mean, if you figure that out mid-meeting, you're more than welcome to go. If you can bring everyone.
I'm pretty sure we bet some, 30 feet circle's pretty big.
But the...
Dragonborn are also pretty big, though.
If everybody's stacked. They're soldiers,
everyone...
you can lift each other up.
Like, can everyone fit into 5 square feet, Jake? Each person can fit into a 5 square feet.
Yeah, mm-hmm, thing. Yeah. Comfortably.
Theoretically, no more than 140 people, but because it's a circle, 5 square feet blocks.
Oh, hang on, 5 square feet?
Like, I'm thinking like one plot on a map.
Oh, like a 5x5?
People are not nearly that fat, though.
That's 25 square feet, though. Like, it's an area. 5 square feet is, like, whatever the root of 5 on each side is.
Yeah.
Like, I think you probably get quite a lot of people in that, but I don't think you get as many people as you think.
He's doing the maths.
How many people do we have again?
Well, then, theoretically, that's less than 30.
Yeah.
There's a space calculator online. Haha.
Also, you don't know where you're gonna end up.
Yeah, I know that's the big if, but it's better than
if you could scatter your army across like space.
You guys can figure this out while me and Zorgo go back out to talk to him because he said he'd let us return. No matter how negotiations go, so I'll bring him some
we'll
cake.
We'll make friends with them.
Yeah, we'll take the cake.
Zorgo, prep your throat for a good speech. We want the
time.
Soldiers. We want the soldiers' chant to start.
How'd you get your scales looking so buff? That sort of thing.
when you guys are in charge and stuff. You know,
what was that?
When you guys are in charge, you gotta sweeten the offer of like, hey, you help us.
Yeah.
You get a better deal at the end, you know. Elsa, here's some cake.
Well, I mean, that's part of the reason I was trying to judge how honorable the man is.
Well, you know, it depends who he's honorable to. If he's honorable to the crown or honorable to the people, and how you
I flatter him a lot.
Gonna go out with cake and a drink for him.
Sure.
Also, Zorgo, if you could carry a drink for each of us. If you could carry a drink for each of us, Zorgo, that would be nice.
I'm a dragonborn, not a fucking octopus.
What do you mean you have to carry two drinks? You have two hands.
Oh, I thought you said for everyone.
No, just
you
for
can't
us.
Walk out there carrying that stuff. Get
we're not gonna give cake to the entire fucking army.
I mean, we've got a lot of cake.
Do we have
the commanders
that?
Of the army? You need to have somebody bringing the cake, like a butler or something.
Or Gek.
No, we're not bringing Gek into this. Actually, quickly, no one's going.
I said time.
To guard Gek. Okay, we're going out with the drink and the cake.
Okay, we're going out.
Yeah, you head out. You see he's a little. He looks a little kind of grumpy, and he kind of looks at you coming with your cake and your drink. So he's like, have you made your decision?
We've discussed it. Yes. Would you like to discuss the terms with a wee drink and a slice of cake? I'll prove it's not poisonous. Aaron takes a sip.
He kind of looks at the wizard and he's like,
you can use the other side of the cup.
Like, very well.
Yeah. Well, so he accepts the cake and the drink?
Yeah, yeah, he's like, sure.
Okay, there you go. Is he eating it?
He's working on it, yeah. He's like, he's got a plate and a cup, and he has to try and eat the thing on the plate, but he doesn't have a free hand. So he like balances it on it.
Just
has to summon someone and be like, there you go, hold that for me.
Oh, yeah, but wizard pal can hold his plate while he drinks.
Also, where did we get plates from?
I don't know, do you not have plates? What the fuck do you guys eat off?
I assume we just put manhandling it and eating cake.
I mean, you're eating like pasta and stuff, like. just a
slice.
What is he expecting from us? Does he expect us to fucking brought plates and teacups up the mountain with us?
All right, okay. So there's no plate. He just he starts eating. He's like, he kind of looks at you expectantly.
I know my brother reasonably okay now with the zero interactions I've had with him. But I don't feel like he'll keep to his word and let my troops go through. Can you honestly swear on your life?
I can give you my word that I have been instructed that your vac will go free.
I see.
He's like, the Scale Lord is ultimately his own man. But I would suggest that at present your little movement is a nuisance rather than a problem. Should this farce be extended, I'm not sure he will extend the same good graces when it falls.
And what is to happen to our party members?
They will face the justice of the scalar courts.
Is that prison or execution? Or yet to be decided?
It is not for me to say.
Be you really?
Okay. Well then, would you also release soldiers of ours that you have in your captive?
Such as?
Nautilus? He is a sentient being and a member of my army.
Strong soldier.
Can't really walk on his own, but he can stab better than most.
He says, I put it to you, Captain, that much as I am happy to speak with you, you are not in a position to bargain.
Whispering now in his ear.
What are we gonna do now?
You say we're not in a position to barter, but do you not want as little casualties as possible here? That's what
certainly.
We seek to. So, in an effort to keep that at a low, I know it may just seem like a weapon to you, but Nautilus is, you know. Nautilus is a person. Tridents are people.
Friend. a comrade.
He kind of, he looks at the wizard, and the wizard's like, it's probably, and he's like, if you and the rest of your party surrender, I will see to it that this Nautilus is distributed to one of your soldiers.
You just chuck in the rest of the belongings because they're just stuff. Doesn't matter to you if we're arrested.
The wizard's like, I think we both know they are somewhat more than stuff. Captain.
Sorry, do you want to use my drift cloak as your bedside light? Just. He's looking at the wizard expecting. He being Aaron. Aaron is looking at the wizard expectingly, seriously seeking an answer.
She's like, no, but you understand. Relics like that are so rarely found. They can't just be dispensed willy-nilly.
I mean, I know a guy who sells this kind of stuff for not bad prices. His name's Graham.
The captain says, can we return to the topic at hand, please? I'm sure you will agree, Captain, that a leader's duty is to those under their command, first and foremost. A disloyal crew does not a successful smuggler make, I'm sure. I suspect Sergeant Cleric there is of a similar mind. Your father made Dragon Knight because he understood the truth of that. This is not a game. The lives of your Avak are on the line here. What will it be? I'm certain Lieutenant Belzeros can attest to the fair treatment of prisoners on our hands. That is, if he is in a fit state to speak. I thought that was an awfully nasty blow that was inflicted upon him.
Wasn't that you?
That stabbed my own man? No.
Wait, what? Okay. Okay. If you hand off Nautilus and my stuff to one of my troops that comes out, we will walk out and surrender.
Yep.
Very well.
I guess Zorga and I return back to the keep.
Sure.
And send out someone to... I'll send out Sargon.
Sargon's not here right now.
So, oh fuck, he's leading the other troop. Oh fuck. Oh fuck it, this is too high work for the elites anyway. It's just gathering stuff. Oh, eeny, meeny, miny, that one. I pick a troop.
You there!
So what's going on?
Get out of there.
Part of the trade.
Trade?
If you go out and retrieve my stuff, don't worry, we've got a plan in place. If you just go out, retrieve my stuff, come back. You should receive 2 tridents, some mariner armor,
a bag,
a drift globe, a bag, very important bag, and most importantly of all, except for maybe the first trident, a shell. Make sure you get the shell.
The bag is also very important.
Okay. Trust me, it's not as important as the shell.
Wait, hold on a sec. Can I just ask what happened to the whole convincing, you know,
saying our stuff soldiers.
Nice
speech. Oh, fuck, yeah.
Talking to them properly instead of just being like, hey, can I have my stuff back?
I mean, I had my own agenda. That mission was handed off to Zorka. I had
other
things
to get
going
about. What?
Balax kind of pushes through the crowd from wherever he's been in prayer, and he says, "What's going on?"
Hang on, Balax. This is either going to kick off into a fight, or we're going to be in a different place, possibly in space, in a few seconds. Give me a minute.
Commander, I think... What?
1 minute, Balax, please. I'm quite busy. I already have some wizard I hardly know shouting in my ear because she thinks she should be the commander. I have Zorgar warming up his throat and just returning. I have this random troop going together, very important.
There was no point for me to interject.
Can I go around and ask everybody to just stand as close together as possible for no particular reason?
Right, Marin is going to approach Muir and make sure the troop is leaving to get stuff and ask Muir, how confident are you this is going to work?
I'm assuming Muir knows, but Izzy doesn't. According to everything I can see online, we can fit more than enough of, there's more than enough space to fit everybody.
Okay, you're going to have to explain to me the maths on this one.
Okay, so on the square footage calculator, on the calculator site, if you put in a 30-foot diameter, it says you get... that seems like a lot of square feet, though, actually. Okay, so that is one side of a square foot, so I could reasonably assume you can fit one-ish people if they squeezed. Maybe they need
two. Dragonborn are pretty big. They probably need
two. Yeah, okay, so assume they need 2 square feet. So hold on, let me just shrink that by...
You could do 1.5
diameter instead. So that gives you 176 square feet. So we do not have more than 170 people with us.
That is the problem you're going to find is that it's a sphere. So like the points that are like, you know, the sphere has a height of 15 feet at its, you know. Mm-hmm. Apex, but as it curves down, the height goes smaller and smaller. As soon as that height drops below a dragonborn's height, they can't fit in there. Like, there's a lot of usable space around the... There's a lot of space around the edge that isn't actually usable.
Do you need to be fully in it, or do you just need part of you to be inside?
You probably... Well, if you're fully within it, it works. If you're not fully within it, it maybe teleports part of you.
Fair enough.
Okay, but the...
It might work.
The square footage for a 30... diameter foot thing, which was why I was originally going off, is 700 square feet, which is quite a lot.
Yeah,
so
that's
weird if you couldn't get everybody in there.
But you would need to divide that by... It depends how many... It depends how big a square someone can be in.
That's what I was saying. So, like, that is one side of a square foot. So, I feel like most people would be able to snuggle in that dragonborn. We need a bit more space, but not that much more space, surely.
My thought on it is you kind of just have to go by the whole 5 foot on a battle map thing, because it's a spell that would theoretically go on a battle map, and also, like, you can't have two people in the same spot on a battle map for those reasons.
Unless they're a halfling.
Sure.
Or other small race, but we don't have many of those.
It's so much space.
Because going into the specifics on it is kind of defeating the point of having different sizes for different things.
But not everybody plays on a battle map.
Can you show me the I don't know how you're trying to teleport people. Can you show me the thing you're using to get, like, the data on? Like, the spell or magic item or whatever?
Oh yeah, sure. It's what we did to get out of Colburn, like intentionally failing the Amulet of Planes thing. I'm just wondering. Yeah. Oop.
What I missed.
I'm not that attached to the idea, but...
The other option is we actually do surrender, because we're getting pretty good at jailbreaks, I'd say.
That was what I was going to say. Like, it would probably... I would put good money on us being able to escape if we got from prison.
We're pretty good at escaping. No, the soldiers are getting sent free.
No. I vote jailbreak yourselves if this doesn't work.
Quick vote. Like, you have 10 seconds to decide either jailbreak or fight to the death.
I vote charisma.
Try that first.
What's Wouldn't charisma? Hurt.
Get Zorogar
charisma to... is rousing speech, actually
explaining. I don't think that's gonna work.
Why you're actually trying to do what you're trying to do. At least.
Okay.
Let's wait until the handoff happens first. Please don't just burst out the doors and start preaching.
We came here with a dream!
But maybe in a show of good faith, so they don't immediately attack us, the party can step outside, as what I was saying. So it still gives us the option.
Here, you know.
I also have another idea where these people don't know I'm part of this army. So no, I could potentially
just like walk away.
I could potentially dimension door to look like I just teleported in to go and tell Captain whatever his fucking name is that like
what the back door.
Some like really serious news means that the army has to go back to the capital straight away. Like, oh, fucking Valisar's been assassinated, and there's
the capital is under attack from the mainland.
Mainland troops are like attacking the capital. You need to return right now. Well, fuck these people. They don't uniform. Have. They're like minuscule on the fucking whole thing of things. Yeah,
really.
I like that plan. Uniform,
if you did that and they found us out, we're probably gonna lose the soldiers go free aspect of things. I don't think they'd do that.
Well, at that point, if it comes down to do that, we're gonna have to just run anyway, because like, what's why are we even like here if we can't take a fight with one army? So if charisma goes badly and, you know, think of a code word. Say that code word and I'll do my plan.
You're wearing the wrong uniform is the biggest issue with this.
I'm wearing my own armor.
I can think. Yeah.
Yeah, but I previously worked for clan fucking magic-y people. I can just say that I was sent because we're the magic people, we can teleport.
Mm-hmm.
The only kind of thing is their wizard might catch on a little bit, but I'm pretty good at convincing shit, and I did used to work there, and I'm kind of well connected with them, so
there might be a history or at least some thread that they know you and they know you've left. How is the handoff going? Aaron's peering out the window.
The soldier is like standing there, like not being given anything, like looking at the window, kind of confused.
Where are we at with the?
I've looked at the spell, and just for so, I'm gonna say that if a dragonborn squeezes, they can get into a 3x3 space, which is 9 square feet. And that gives you roughly 75 people you could take if everyone absolutely fucking crammed in. But, and it's an important but, I ruled the Amulet Plains the wrong last time, because it sends you to a random destination. It doesn't say you all arrive in the same random destination. I think it means that it scatters you across the plane that you arrive on, if that makes sense. That's consistent with how it works in other stuff.
We'll see that.
Because you travel to a random destination. So you can teleport like 75 soldiers, but they'd go somewhere totally random. It's the Amulet of the Plains, magic item.
Is that an establishment?
It is, aye.
I thought it's the plural you, I would have assumed.
Well, it can kind of be read either way.
Either way, it sounds like it's not going to transport.
If you're willingly, yeah. The way I would probably rule it is if you rolled and mucked it up, then, if you rolled and failed the check, then you'd probably all go at the same place. But if you are deliberately misfiring an amulet, by deliberately trying to fuck with the casting of the spell, then it probably teleports you to random locations each.
Okay, sure.
Would that mean that it would be random planes for everyone?
No, you'd all go to the same plane, but you'd arrive in different locations, is probably how I would say it.
Well, that's a fucking wild card.
Either way, probably can't fit anybody. I say we jailbreak, because it's fun.
Fuck it, let's go for the 3-tier strap. Go out. Zorgel can preach his heart out. Fucking.
Can I pray to my god before going out?
Yes, that's my name.
Zorath can do whatever the fuck the portal. If that doesn't work, we just go, oh, well, we tried and we surrender. And then we jump back.
Actually, never
mind. I'm going to quickly leave instructions with Baylan.
Yes, Commander.
Baylax, this has become an extremely complicated 3-tier plan. In this 3-tier plan, the hope is that you and the army should get to walk away. Myself and the party will be taken as hostages to the capital, but it's fine. As you know, we're masters at jailbreaking. Your mission will be to regroup with Sargon and the rest of the forces.
How will we do that when this new location is not known to any of us and accessible only by air?
This is why you're the captain here, Valax. Good luck!
Figure it out, bitch!
Commander, if I can be frank, I think this is a poor plan.
Okay, suggest the battle continue in less than 5 seconds. Go!
1, 2,
and there we go. We're going with the 3-2 plan. we have a new wizard division. One of them probably has sending and hasn't met them, so can't do anything, but it's a step.
Yeah, new wizard division.
Worst comes to worst, you scatter the army really thinly across the land, go underground until we summon you. That's worst comes to worst. Oh, also if you want, there's a Goonies cave on the east coast.
If you can be fucked walking.
If you could get there stealthily enough. If you might have to clear it out, caves. It's a good smuggler spot, so.
Yeah, that's probably doesn't know what the Goonies are.
He looks so baffled. He kind of looks around.
Things go absolutely awful. It's been an honor, Baylax, and good luck on your future.
Likewise, Commander.
I would offer you, a good referral, but I might be dead. So, and if I'm not, anyway, good luck. Oh, and if the 3-tier plan fails horrendously, then we're just gonna battle.
All right, sir.
Also, in case you missed me saying it before, assign a guard to Gek. Actually, Gek is in your care now. Look after Gek.
Of all the things you said, this is the one that gets the strongest reaction.
The most.
He's like, all right, sir.
Because in your care, if I don't come back, I guess you should return him to Feral on the ship, but I can't plan out the next 5 years of your life in the next few seconds. I've got things to do.
Sure. The sad calls from outside, he says,
Exactly. Well, where's my stuff?
quick last aside. I've also got the Helm of Telepathy, so along with Soroth's thing, I could probably cast Suggestion on the Wizard Lady, who's probably the most likely to know something's wrong, and say, yeah, this is totally, yeah, this sounds legit. So I'll do that as well.
How likely is she to see through that, though? She's, I imagine, quite a skilled wizard.
It doesn't say anyone notices you doing it, so don't see any harm.
Okay. Yeah, what's the response to where's my shit?
He said our agreement was clear.
It was.
Don't surrender.
Give me my stuff.
After you are in our care.
What? Do you really think handing me my stuff back is going to turn the tides and turn me into a one-man army? I don't know what the tales are.
I don't wish to take any chances. You cannot use it either way. Why does it bother you?
How about this? You give it to my troop. He stands there while we come out.
And then he can come in.
And then he comes in once more, right in front of you.
I tire of this.
So do I.
Then come out and let's be done with it.
I don't think he's going to like the speech I'm about to give.
I don't think so either.
Just do it from the heart, man. Just do it.
Really go for it.
I have a speech, but I don't think he's going to like it.
Let's just step out. The sign will be like,
Hey, very well.
Alrighty then. Naren will say alrighty then.
And that'll be your signs for us.
Yes.
Okay.
Alrighty then. That seems normal enough for a smuggler.
Almost something better.
You know, try your best, though. Try your best.
I have a lot of things to think about.
Okay, gone with R.
R starts psyching themselves up. They're getting ready to act.
Okay, we're just gonna step out now. We're not gonna piss them off anymore.
Am I giving a speech?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hands in the air, but really go for it. Come on, buddy.
Okay.
You get plus six. That's a roll.
Sure. So you guys are stepping outside.
Yeah.
Yep.
Sure.
The most courageous way I can. You know,
so are all of you stepping outside?
I'm
not.
Sorry, it's not.
The party members.
Sure.
Everyone else.
Okay.
Rurek has just signed up to this.
Sure. So yeah, you step out. And facade nods. And he says, Manacles.
Go, just go as soon as we step out. Speech.
Wait, what's his name, sir?
His name is Captain Facade.
Beseech the army, not just him.
We came here because we saw people downtrodden. Downtrodden by a corrupt leader.
Yeah, woo!
I'm thinking, okay?
This comes out a lot smoother.
He takes the first pair of manacles, he says, he points it at her and says, step forward.
Alrighty then.
Alrighty! Nothing, try it all!
You hear shouted from within the tent.
Now, can you give us a perception check, please? And Zorgar, actually.
Oh boy, here come the drinks.
Oh wait, am I going?
It's up to Zora.
Okay, so well, she did hear alrighty then.
Woo!
I was hoping this would be a little later.
He brought out the manacles. What was I supposed to? When you bring out manacles, he means business.
So they didn't buy my speech?
No, they were like, they looked at it and they looked at you.
I had plus 9 to charisma.
Sometimes you can't persuade anyone.
Damn.
Oh, like, well, let's see if this persuasion works.
I have plus 8 to persuasion.
I mean, well, give us a roll and let's see what the reaction is. It's a hard one. Like,
is it a charisma roll or a persuasion roll?
Come on.
Like, no matter how good you roll, you're not going to be able to get this entire army to defect, but you might get some sympathy.
But I get plus 6 from Izzy, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
How is Mira doing that?
Just, you know, really back. You know, I mean, yeah.
plus 13 and you got 18.
Yeah, like some people are like, he's got a good voice, doesn't he?
We are downtrodden.
Are we downtrodden? I don't know, maybe. Sometimes I was expecting him to make some points, but he didn't really do it. He just went, we're downtrodden. I mean, yeah.
I felt quite downtrodden after I was at the pub last time.
Stage two is in motion.
Right, so Sarath, what are you doing?
Hold on. Let me see the map so I can... What's the capital of this place called before I start fucking up words?
Big Boy Town.
Karen Tall, is Karen that Tall. The big place?
This one, yeah.
Okay.
Karen Tall.
Can I have the Despin ready for when after Sarath says or whatever they're going to say?
Sure, yeah.
Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna dimension door off to the side of the army. Suddenly, you know, appear, put my hands up and say, what the fuck was his name? Hold on a second, I've got the notes.
I also...
Captain Vassad! I bring news from Karad Tal. I've been sent by Clan Ulrus. I needed to send word urgently. There's an attack. There's been an attack from the mainland.
On Karatel,
you're needed to come back immediately. Can I just preface this that Emma's bad at acting, but Sarf is very good at it.
Sure, I'll give us a performance check.
Can I do wait, it might be all the same. Hold on, let me check. Yeah, it's all the same. I can do it. Where is my page? Was I able to get a plus six before I went off? Or is that... Can you only do that to one person?
It counts as a reaction, so I don't know how much time is, but 6 seconds have passed.
Yeah,
but...
probably, yeah, you probably got a reaction, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah,
I'm doing my best to look shocked and a puddle.
Plus six, so that's... 18, yeah. Is 18? Yes.
Yeah.
18.
I cast suggestion on the wizard.
What are you suggesting to her? Because you gotta say it to her.
Okay.
I think. Let me double check.
Yeah, you do. You have to, like,
give suggest them a course of activity.
And there's no chance she'll be like, hang on, you're trying to cast suggestion on me.
It doesn't say that they recognize, and it usually does.
If it fails, they're basically just like, no, what the fuck. But also everyone else hears you say the suggestion to them. So it's like,
oh, I see. Oh, right. Oh, I see. Okay, that makes it a lot trickier. I did not realize that. Yeah.
Imagine giving that to Sarath.
The wizard looks from the sad to Sarath.
Would I have an inspiration at all? Because I feel like this is a pretty big moment for Sora. This is.
You probably got. Yeah.
Can I? Yeah, use inspiration, get advantage.
Sure.
Because I. I did roll. Did I roll a 4? Is that what happened? I can't remember. Come on, this time. Great.
Five.
One better. 19.
Hey!
Thank you. Dice.
I mean, you know, the sad looks quite concerned, and so does the wizard. And then the wizard says, "Why did no one contact me?"
It was too important. They had to send someone in person.
She does not seem to buy that. She's like, she turns and says, "Let me verify this."
Shit.
And you see her like.
Yes.
Who was the attack from?
We didn't think that.
Hold on, let me think.
Did the wizard just ask a question to one of us?
Vassad would have said, who's the attack from? To Zorinth. Like, he looks like he's kind of buying it.
I was told it was from the mainland, something about finding scale troops on the mainland and...
But there have been no scale troops on the mainland.
That's a lie?
I...
He says, what do Clanoris expect us to do? We cannot... It'll be days before we reach the Karen top.
Well, there's no knowing how many more ships are going to arrive. We need every last man. I've been told.
All right, well,
the people here are, they pose no real threat compared to the ships.
Well, we'll be swiftly putting them in manacles and then taking them to the capital. So this aligns nicely. Step forward. He turns to Aaron.
Hang on a minute. I've just realized this isn't in my best interest.
No, it's in your men's interest.
I mean, I feel like they've seen through the ploy at this point. The wizard is about to verify that this is false.
So the wizard turns to... Okay. Turns, he's like... Cool. Like, hang on, sorry. So the wizard kind of turns, right? And like pulls the... like, whatever, like, magic was going on stops. And she turns to Fasad and is about to say something. And then from the clouds above, there burst, like, these five... swooping shapes that like they fan out and they do like kind of like a sort of like almost like a Red Arrows routine, you know, like fly around. and then nice. One of the guys at the front, like one of the drakes, like kind of peels down towards the front, and then kind of, so sorry, what was Naren about to do?
Oh, Naren's now gazing at whoever's riding on this thing. Is it his old friend?
No, this is some totally new guy. He's kind of, yeah. He looks like he's coming down to land. So if you're going to do something, you can do something kind of before he lands.
Just like, as he approaches, he's like, you better hand over my stuff as you're clipping these manacles. Like, I mean, like, as it goes in their hand, you click it close.
Once we have you all in our custody.
No. Halfway. This is what we agreed.
He says, so I have many things, Captain. I am not a fool.
If I'm chained up the user of these items, why does it matter?
he just kind of like looks at you and like gestures with the manacles again. And then there's this thud as the drake lands. The rider like pushes himself off. He does like a little like jump off and he lands. Kind of looks sort of very pleased with himself. He's this black dragonborn. Which you see when he removes his, like, he's wearing this, like, silver glass armor, and he's got one sword, and his helmet is stylized to look like a dragon skull, and he, you know, removes it, and you see this black dragon born under there, and he kind of pops his helmet under an arm, and says,
He has a dragon skull. Why is he wearing one on his head?
Is that like one of those little Russian doll things?
Like it kind of looks cool, but it also kind of looks like he's trying quite hard. and kind of as the wizard is, as Captain Fasad is talking to Naren and the wizard's about to say something, this guy just sort of like kind of like announces, he says, "Hail! I understand we're here to save the day." And then
you're a bit late.
Naren, give us an insight check.
Anyone
is
able to do anything to that wizard, please do.
I
can stab them with a spear.
You see Captain Fasad like look over at him and he does something with his face and you're not entirely sure if it's like, oh thank god these guys are here, or man, this fucking arsehole. it's one of the two and you're not entirely sure which.
I think I can guess.
That's the best suggestion word you could use if it comes down to it is just quiet or silence, and then start chatting. You know, and then she won't be able to say anything for.
Oh yeah, actually, can I convincingly frustratedly yell, "Oh, why don't you all just go home?" At her.
Oh, grow up.
Sure. Yeah. So it does say the suggestion must be worded in such a manner as to make the course of action sound reasonable.
if there's a war and Soroth is telling them they need to go, so.
Sure, okay. So what's your spell save? What's the spell save DC on it?
Oh yeah, let me see.
Does it use your one or does it have a specific one?
It doesn't say, so I assume it's what it is.
Save DC 13.
Well, on the... Oh, never mind.
Sure, okay. So, I mean, she fails her save. But she has literally just been told that's fucking nonsense. So she's like she looks kind of conflicted, and she's not really sure. She kind of watches what's playing out with the Drake guy who's just turned up, and this ad, and the Drake guy kind of walks over, and sort of kind of so now you're just kind of like standing in front of his ad right now.
Yeah.
Sure. He kind of like the Drake guy kind of like. Walks up and kind of like pats you on the shoulder and puts his arm around the side, and he kind of looks at you. He says, "Putting this lot in body bags, eh?" And the side says, "Alive. I can do alive."
No, you can when it's this easy.
And he looks at Aaron and he says, "Hope you're ready for a rough journey. The talons can dig in a little." And he winks at you.
I'm sorry, Captain. Captain. Is this the kind of people you want to be working with for the rest of your life? Look at how he treats you, let alone us. Let alone the rest of the people on this island.
He sighs, and he turns, he says, "Thran, we've had reports from the points over to Sarathy. We've had reports that there are a mainland attack on Cairn Tal." And Thran kind of the. Who appears to be this guy's name is Thran, the Drake Rider. He kind of like was. We just flew over Cairn Tal, there was nothing. And the wizard says, "I verified with the Cerulean, there has been no reports of attack that Clan Ulrus are aware of. It's possible we should investigate further." And Fasad says, he kind of looks at Sarnath.
I swear.
Come closer.
Come over here. And it literally, it's only just happened. The only reason they haven't.
Well, what kind of attack was it? Naval? Land? Here?
I was told naval, but I wasn't there.
Well, who sent
you? I don't know. What's the name of the claw? The claw. What's the name? I can't remember his fucking name. What is the
claw?
The head honcho. You know who I'm talking about, Jake.
Yeah, I mean, Zarth would know that guy's name. His name's Morin Ulrus.
Morin Ulrus. Yeah, got it in my notes. I got it in my notes.
What if she, the wizard, that knows Morin?
Well, then we got to make sure she don't cast sending again. It was. Is there like a title that I should use instead of saying his name, like the like out of respect, you know?
I mean, you know, like you know, his title is the Blue Claw, so you could refer to him just as that, or as like Claw Ulrus or Claw Morin or something like that would potentially be a way to go. Sir Morin, maybe.
It came directly from Claw Ulrus. They haven't put the word out to everyone yet. They don't want to cause a panic.
Vasad says, he kind of looks at it and says, "Well, verify with Morin."
Can someone please do something?
And he moves to actually like fully put the manacles on her at this point.
Is it the same manacles Naren had on before?
Did you bust out those manacles?
Good question. I don't know.
It's probably just new manacles. Like
are they fresh? New?
They look pretty new. Like they're like yeah, it looks like a pretty fresh set of manacles. And the guy is waiting, one of the soldiers is waiting beside him for like a second pair.
You know, dude, the problem is that I can't cast sending to Mr. Ulrich to be like, hey, I'm doing this fucking thing.
Well, oh, you're not either. Right.
Let's hope they're always watching.
Yeah.
If you guys had something that could contact her, maybe. Just saying.
Hang on a minute. I know you're arresting us. Let me just hop on the stone real quick.
I mean, you could do it slowly.
Are you resisting in any way, Naren? Because he's like about to like clamp him in.
Verbally, being like, how about item per person?
He clicks the first chunk in, like the first wrist, and moves to the second one. And Thran kind of like looks you up and down. He spots your scale. He says, "Nice scale, asshole. Your mom paint that for you?"
Oh.
Sick burn, man.
Nothing's gonna do it.
Baron is quite amused by this person, and he actually laughs.
He looks kind of confused at that reaction. Yep, yeah, that's gonna click the other manacle in unless you're gonna do anything to stop him.
Nope.
Sure. You're bound in one pair, and then he takes the second pair, and looks like he's gonna put a second pair of manacles on your arms.
I appreciate you think I'm this strong. Thank you.
He just kind of raises an eyebrow.
Shit, question.
Yeah.
If I use the spell Skyrite, and it says words, can those words just be some squiggly smoke rising from a burning city looking things?
There'd be some kind of role involved. It wouldn't be able to rise from the city, it would be in the sky.
Yeah. But
you could put a smoke-like thing in the sky, but there wouldn't be an obvious source to it. Does that make sense? It would just be like, it might just look like a big cloud.
Okay, fair. Okay. Grasping at straws here.
This Drake Rider guy is still kind of like, he's kind of like looking around. The other Drakes have kind of like landed on they've like landed nearby. And this Thran dude is kind of like looking around, and he kind of crosses his arms and started looking at the soldiers after his little joke, see if any of them kind of, some of them kind of like, sort of like, chuckle. He says, aren't you supposed to have some kind of like fork or something? A spoon? Where's your spoon, man?
Naren is just looking at him, smiling.
Not much of a talker. Naren's got to give him.
I have a question. Does anyone know if Rurik has the counterspell or dispel magic?
Usually I have dispel magic. I don't think it counterspells on the correct list.
Okay.
That's when they don't recall him ever counterspelling anything before.
Okay, never mind. Would a nice, well-timed dispel magic stop ascending?
Let me read the spell.
I wish I could telepath to Mr. Xeros or whatever and be like, hey, go talk to your dad and tell him to not answer the next sending.
Don't pick up the phone.
Dad?
Oh, spoiler, sorry.
You let something slip there.
Yeah, if you got it right, if you got the timing right, you could, or you could, it would maybe only stop the message like halfway through or something. It would be hard to get the timing right, because there's no, like, real, like, it's difficult, it's all happening in the head, so it's kind of difficult to see when the message actually begins to be, like, said. If that makes sense, it's not impossible. But, you know, the wizard would probably know if a spell she was casting suddenly didn't. work?
That could happen for reasons on the other end as well.
It could, yeah.
And yeah, I'm gonna say Rick's gonna try and sneakily do it. He's short, he can hide behind people.
Sure, okay.
And also it might cause more worry for her personally if a message from Mr. Claw mm-hmm. cuts out halfway through.
Okay, roll a D100, I guess, to see how good he does at timing it. It's kind of just your chance.
96.
Pretty good, yeah.
Finally a good roll.
A really dramatic moment.
Yeah, the wizard says, no answer from Marin, Captain.
He'll be so busy right now. There's so much that's happening. There's so much to do.
So where were you told about this? Were you in Carantal?
I wasn't. I was at the side of Morris.
Who was in Carantal? So were you in Carantal or were you not in Carantal?
Well, I didn't want to reveal in front of things where he was, but yes.
It's a fairly accepted fact that the claws
not
are in Carantal.
Not for them, but okay.
Captain, I do find it difficult to believe this story, but there is some circumstantial evidence for it. I suggest we make all haste back to Carantal either way. And she kind of looks at the soldier and says, manacles here then. At this point, Vassad has clunked Naren's second pair of manacles in and sort of like passes them off to the troops nearby, who start to kind of like, or they're going to certainly attempt to process you into the army.
Naren is going to say, I'm not moving until I see my stuff handed off. You can put us all in manacles, that's fine.
All right then, well,
but I will not move.
And Vassad points at Zarger and says, step forward. He's going to manacle you in. And same as Naren, this Drake Rider dude kind of back chats you a little. He says, you're the one whose own father ordered an attack on you, aren't you? I thought things were restrained between me and my old dad. If I could be a fly on the wall when they throw you two in the same cell. He's like, you're talking to me? Do you have any idea who you're dealing with?
Do you have any idea who you're dealing with?
And Vassad says, Thran. He kind of like, sort of like, kind of stares right down and like, kind of narrows his eyes a bit.
I'm gonna turn to the captain. I'm gonna say, with all due respect, Captain, there's really no time for this. We must make haste.
Well, if you, we're only going to, you know, you're talking about minutes after 3 days have passed by the time we get to Carantal. Respectfully.
They look like they're putting up a fuss to me, but.
Well, if you want to go any faster, then take these manacles and help.
Play along, you might be able to.
Okay, I'll do that.
Sure. He gives you two pairs of manacles, and he kind of sort of looks at me and says, no, the human needs smaller ones. Smaller manacles! and he passes you two pairs of manacles and says, restrain her then. And points at Muir.
I'm going up to Muir Is there any way to close the manacles and pretend to lock them but not actually lock?
Not really.
Okay.
I don't really know how manacles
jailbreak
work.
Jailbreak plans, don't worry about me.
Okay.
I think in order for them to be fixed in place, they have to be locked. I think.
Okay.
Or there'd be some obvious, like, it would either be like there's to be like a pin that wasn't in, that is quite obviously not in, that would mean that they're not locked.
I'm gonna make it quite obvious, like, when I go up to Mir to like lock them, I'm gonna like very visually show her what the key looks like.
Sure, okay. So yeah, I mean, is Rogar gonna resist in any way being manacled? Because they're just gonna manacle you in.
What is happening? It's okay.
I see this as a positive. We get a free ride to the palace, break out, kill Balistar. Seems fine. That'll be great.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay. So they put two pairs of manacles on Zorgar as well, and they kind of direct him to stand next to Naren. And Rurek's going to come over next. And presumably, if no one else has been resisted, he's not going to resist either. Thran looks like he considers, you know, popping a short joke and kind of looks at Zorgar and thinks a bit better of it.
There's one thing that Patrick asked me to do, which was...
Sure.
What's it called? Using concordance?
Uh-huh.
I don't really know how that works or what it can...
We might summon an angel.
Okay.
I
was wondering if it was one of those things that could do that thing where, you know, when he, like, summoned a whole army to us.
Oh, there's divine intervention for that.
Divine intervention.
Which he could use. He's not using it for a while.
Is that something I... could try and get the whole army to get scooted out and everyone?
We should do that, yeah.
Maybe?
Is there something bad that could happen if I do that? Because I don't want to do anything.
No, there's no real downside to it. It just means that you couldn't use it for like a week or something, I think.
Okay, yeah. He's gonna pray and hope that we get like completely scooted out of there by Altius or whatever.
Here's Altius.
That'll be convenient.
That'd
be great.
Okay.
Sure. I don't know if I control where we end up, but...
Yeah, so if Altius intervenes, you can't use this feature again for 7 days, otherwise you can use it after you finish a long rest. So, the first step is to describe the assistance Rurek seeks.
Angel army.
We'd like to get a swift escape for all of his allies.
Do you wait until my stuff
to
is
a safe place?
What? Okay. Do you
wait until my stuff is banned to the
allies
troops?
Include
Pointy Boy.
Nautilus, yeah.
Nautilus
is an ally.
Sure, okay.
Yeah, but this is the ex-boyfriend of the lady who made it.
Well, I'm just gonna say allies, okay? Because there's lives of like hundreds of people here.
All right, then roll 1d100 and try and roll under 13.
Okay.
So, out of curiosity, sorry to interrupt this big moment, but is Naren within telepathic communication with Nautilus again?
Is it kind of cuts in on it?
Yeah.
I can't.
Naren! This back sucks!
Oh, okay, I'm rolling. Nope.
Nope. Ryan does a little prayer and... Is that coming? Nothing happens. And they click the set of manacles in. And then they click the second set of manacles in. And they kind of process him next to Naren and Zrungar. And as Sarith is manacling Muir, that's probably also happened by this point, I assume.
Yeah.
So then it's just Raffin left. So the captain kind of beckons Raffin over. And holds a set of manacles out, ready.
We're all being manacled.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how I feel about this.
We can escape easier. I wouldn't worry about it.
That's true. I could just turn into a duck and fly away.
There are also metal manacles, which might kind of grate on Raffin a bit. I don't know.
That's true.
Depends how he feels about things.
Sarif is just like, whenever they're not like, whenever they're faced away from all the army, they're kind of looking at all of you guys, being like, "So what's going on here?" Like, what?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll submit to the manacles then.
Sure. they click them in.
I've been watching Game of Thrones all summer. This is not how these battles go. You're supposed to meet outside, trade insults, slap each other about a bit, and then go and have a fight.
I agree.
Well, we offered them cake, and now we're getting captured.
And manacled ourselves.
Yeah, okay. So, with all of you guys manacled, you're sort of kind of bundled into the same bit. And then Vasad says, "All right, bring out the..." He looks at Arian, "Bring out the possessions." Takes a couple seconds as they kind of gather all the stuff, and they kind of bring your Nautilus kind of coming into focus. He's like, Naren, what's going on? I'm moving.
Hey, Nautilus, told you I'd get you back.
Are we about to bust out of here?
Absolutely. We're going to be in maybe two separate places again. However, what? You'll be free. And then I will break free. You've been with me on many jailbreaks. Have faith in me.
Well, you only get out of jail because I'm there.
That's not true. They always take you off me every time I get arrested, and mm-hmm. I always have to come save
and
you.
And I muck about with them. I talk them down. I show them what for. And then you get out, and yeah.
Is that what you've done here?
Well, no.
Exactly.
They're very resistant. They put me in a box. God, I've done my best. I've shouted.
The was formed by Orisa, defeated by a box.
Well, you've not blown the shell yet. We're supposed to blow the shell so we can get the heart, and then this is your fault.
You want me to blow the shell right now?
Well, it's not going to do any use here, is it?
It might.
Kraken's water-based. It doesn't go on land.
For now.
You know nothing.
It's all going according to plan. Don't worry, Nautilus.
What's the plan? Explain the tiers!
There's three tiers. Well, on the third tier, it's fine.
You can just say you're crying.
You can see into my mind. You know I'm not crying.
How would you guys have been crying? So what's going on there? And then he kind of, it's like a filter has been lifted off him as they open the box and pull him out. He's like, there you are, I see you! And then he gets handed off.
Is he saying this aloud or in my head?
A little bit of both. It cuts in and out loud. And then Thran kind of like watches this, and he's like, "Is that the spoon there?"
That's Nautilus, Fury of the Waves. You'll get to know him quite well.
Kind of looks at you and says, "I'm looking forward to it."
Take these manacles off and we can do it.
Fight.
And he nods his head over to Vasad. He says, unfortunately, Grandpa has other plans. Over and he as the handoff is taking place, he kind of like picks Nautilus up before he gets handed off, and like Naren, he's touching me, Naren. And kind of like flicks it and scrapes him in the dirt and stuff. He just kind of throws him on the ground and kind of walks back and says, and then the soldier's like hurriedly picking him up. He's like, he's taking the stuff and then.
What's your name again? Sorry, I forgot.
You're talking to the...
Yeah.
Third again? He's, Thran.
Right.
Don't forget it again. sure.
I probably will. Has all the stuff been handed?
Yeah.
The, like, everything that Marin had on it.
Yeah, they kind of...
Okay.
He has to make two trips. He takes the stuff and he comes back and he's like, shit. He runs back and grabs the shell and he's like, eh, runs away again.
Get the shell.
You're pretty sure you've seen all the stuff that you had. Go in there. You can hear kind of like chat inside the temple.
Stuff.
Did you get the shell?
Patrick has told me that he's hiding some kind of thing in his beard.
You might need to be more specific.
It's something that helps him pray. I think it's probably a spellcasting thing. He says Altius pray thingy. He's hiding that in his beard.
Okay.
Just so you know.
Altius pray thingy.
Yeah.
In the catalogue of his
beard.
Yeah.
Oh, sure, okay, yeah, that's fine.
He's focused.
Can Mira make sure, however they're getting carted off, that she's standing next to Hrafn, or near Hrafn?
It looks like you're gonna get, carried by drakes.
Yes!
Yeah,
you guys are getting carried by Thran.
Is it two people per drake?
well, there's one, two... There's only five of you, right?
Uh-huh.
Then there's one per drake.
Shit. Okay.
We can wait till we arrive.
I've got so many...
Yeah, befriend the drakes.
Oh, that's an idea, actually.
I will make charisma work once this dang session, I swear.
I
was nice to baby Drake.
It's true, maybe this is baby Drake's mother and it all is just one big circle. That small deep long ago has saved us.
Vizaz kind of looks at Nara after the handoff and he says, happy?
I'll be happy when I know my troops are safe.
Certainly.
What was the deal again? Just because my mum phoned and I think I might have missed something. We're surrendering.
We're surrendering, getting taken to Carantol, our troops are being set free, and Nautilus, all of my stuff is back with the army. We're relying on our amazing jailbreaking skills here.
And that you're not going to get executed straight away as soon as you arrive in Carantol.
Come on, what kind of evil villain would he be if he didn't give a grandiose speech first?
Exactly!
Fucking, come on now.
Fasad turns to Thran and says, load them up then. And then he kind of calls to the temple. He says, Captain Gar, step outside, please.
Hang on.
So there's like some noise inside. Right. You can't really hear what's going on. Does that provoke any kind of reaction from you guys?
Can I have a reminder of who that is?
Captain Gar, that's Baylax.
His name is Baylax Gar?
Yeah.
Ah, good to know.
I feel it's kind of set your child up to be an evil kind of person.
It's G-A-U-R. It's not gore. just similar sound.
Priest of evil!
Hang on, he's a member of a thing.
And a wanted man.
I like how you left that out until after the manacles were on. Claimed to be an honorable man, and yet you hide behind the line.
I am. The innocent folk will go free.
I don't mean to condemn them all here, but surely staging a coup is... no one is innocent. So why are you singling him out?
I'm just following my instructions.
Actually, I just realized, would Zarsen have actually been cuffed?
Widely
known as a member of the party?
Not really. I mean, they already had Zarsen. And they, you know, they didn't seem to consider him part of the, like, command structure.
Zarsen just came for the hell of it?
Like, it just seemed like he was just a guy. There's no movement from inside the temple, and Vizad calls out again. He says, Captain Gar! And then a few moments go by, and then Balax opens the door, and he kind of immediately like sees what's going on outside and like looks at Naren as if to say, like,
Sorath. Naren is just trying to give Sorath like the.
Eh?
Don't want to be too meta and tell you, but just.
Me?
Yes.
What? I already did my thing.
Yeah, but Balak's getting taken wasn't part of the plan.
I can't do shit about that.
Naren doesn't know. Naren's just hopeful. Fucking deuce.
Vasad says, step forward, please. You are being taken captive in accordance with your bounty.
This was not part of our deal.
So I'm sorry you feel that way.
How close is he to Nera?
Not that close. Like 30 feet away?
Within headbutt range.
No.
What about flying headbutt?
I mean, if you're currently kind of like restrained, but if you like broke free, you could kind of charge him, yeah. That might not go very well for you. He's kind of surrounded by soldiers, yeah. But he's, you can make him do it.
Well, is he to be trialed?
Aye. Same as the rest of you.
In Carantol?
Aye. Step forward, Captain. And Balak's kind of like, you know, he looks around, he's like, well, fuck. Kind of slowly trudges forward.
Is this the same guy and they're related? Is this these two?
No.
Okay.
The guy who's related is down the hill. Oh, wait, does your promise not include the army down the hill? Will they attack my troop?
I'm afraid I can't speak for Captain Karth, but I understand.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
We can stop off and I can discuss with them, I'm certain.
If you could, that would be great.
The wizard says, I'm not sure we have time for that, Captain, given the situation in the capital. I still can't raise anyone.
The capital will be fine.
Vizad says, kind of looks at the wizard and says, perhaps you're right. He kind of looks at Thrani and says, load them up, take them to the capital. We will follow on foot. We will descend the hill, discuss with Captain Karth, the rest of these Vakar to go free, and Thrani's like...
Because surely right. Karth is going to head to the capital as well.
Possibly. It's difficult to say. The translator says, keep trying. And yeah, they're going to load you up onto drakes. As they load you up, they're going to have the drakes pick you up by their talons. And fly you to the capital.
Alright.
Balax looks like he's going to be with the... it seems like he's going on foot. With the army. But yeah, are you guys doing anything, or are you just going to sort of consent to being picked up and flown?
Could I ask that Balax is given the exclusive treatment along with us and sent with us by air? He's my captain. He's equally as guilty of these crimes.
That's for the courts to decide. Thran says, we want to make sure we give you special attention. And he kind of looks at Aaron and says, you're with me.
Oh boy. Looking forward to it. Have I been looking at Thran for more than a minute?
Yeah.
Has hit points more than one?
How many hit points you got?
100 and something.
Yeah, he's got more than you.
Wait, what?
Already knew that before.
A region of 100.
He's got more than 200.
108? Does that make a difference?
No, he's still got more than you.
I really want a meta talk, but I know we can.
Grass, yeah. The wizard turns to Sarth and says, what were your instructions after you came here?
I'm to return to... Who am I returning to?
I feel like I recognize you. Do we know each other?
I don't think we know each other, but I'm pretty recognizable most of the time. I stand out most of the time. I wouldn't be surprised if you see me going around in, What? Hold on. I have to kind of do my notes. Where the In Ulrich's place, you know the place. Elcaster and all that.
Sorry, I interrupted you. What are your assignments after this?
I'm to go back to I have to go to the Ulrich's vaults and inform them also. Or, well, I suppose they're probably already informed by now. But I was supposed to go there. And
I see. So they restrain Balex, and then Vasad calls out to the temple again. He says, the rest of you are free to go. Thank you for your cooperation. Then he looks at Thren and says, well, there's no sense in keeping them here any longer. And Bran says, sure, yeah, we'll take them direct to the palace. And this had known some, they're gonna just load you up into talons, and then they're gonna fly you towards the capital. Unless anyone else is gonna do anything.
Anyone gonna make a fuss of them getting to see the army walk free? So you don't get taken away, straight away. And delay some time. Perhaps.
Just make sure they're releasing the armies, obviously.
I said the army was free to go. But if you guys are getting taken away in the talons of something, you're not going to actually be able to see the army getting away.
That's true.
But I can't say that right now, so never mind. Whatever.
Fasad turns to address the rest of the army and says, he kind of sighs. He says, all right, men. We make for the other side of the mountain. Rendezvous with the 8th, and debrief on the situation. He turns to the wizard, he says, continue trying to raise the capital. I want to know what's going on. And he kind of basically is just like, roll out! And everyone starts kind of like mobilizing. It takes a while, but they're kind of moving towards heading off. And the rest of you just get bundled into Drake talons, and then the drakes take off and are going to fly towards Garantal. So it is only 20 past 9, and normally we play till 10, but probably want to, it feels like quite a good place to stop and pick up there next week and find out what the heck's going to happen in the capital. It might be something we need Burak for as well.
Yeah.
Potentially.
Maybe. I feel it set me back because I know you planned out all this warfare stuff and then we surrendered immediately.
how outmatched were we battle wise?
Well, I mean, so Zarzan.
I think.
Because there, I feel like there wasn't even the discussion of actually fighting.
That was at the beginning. But,
So you had more units than them, but because some of your guys are away, you'd have had to have assigned like casualties, so you'd have started on a deficit of dudes, and it wouldn't have been an impossible fight. But it would not have been, it was not one that favored you guys. Anyways, yeah, I guess we'll, we might play next week, we might play some number of weeks after that. So if you watch the stream, cheers for watching, and we'll see you, then, I guess. Bye.